Windows 10 was announced in the late of 2014, and boy was I excited to finally have it on my personal computer. Microsoft was doing a pretty good job marketing their product, showing off its most relevant features, some innovative and some just step back to some familiar features from earlier version of the well-known operating system. Yes, I'm looking at the star menu here. Later on, Microsoft released a beta version of Windows 10, available for free for the community, mainly for technical users. But what got everybody's attention is their other announcement that it will be totally free as an upgrade from Windows 8 or even Windows 7. That was the day everybody's excitement about Windows 10 final release just got doubled, and of course, including me. Microsoft has been making newer builds of Windows, and they have been accessible to beta testers, mainly the people who have downloaded the technical preview of Windows.
A little bit of the interface is
different. I've been watching reviews of every build. Microsoft was doing a pretty good job not only refining it and making it more flexible, stable, and less buggy, but also they have been introducing new features in terms of both functionality and user interface and overall experience. As a technical user myself, I wanted so badly to install Windows 10 in my machine, but the lack of the time due to my final year's project and many more stuff I've been working on really got in the way.
This conference is all about celebrating and challenging the creativity, the ingenuity that you all bring to build new and great things on top of platform innovations that we make available to you.
At the start of June, Microsoft finally announced the release date on Windows 10. That would be 29th July 2015. So then I finally decided not to actually install the beta version and install the final build when it's finally out. I was more excited than ever. I highlighted the date and waited for it the whole time. When Windows 10 was finally out, I haven't had the time to sacrifice upgrading, especially with the risk of losing all the software and maybe some files that I really needed at the time. So after a few days, when I finally decided to do it, I didn't get the notification to upgrade like anyone else on their computer. I tried checking for updates on Windows 8.1, maybe it will bring that notification back, but it didn't really work. I found a quick solution to upgrade manually by downloading some software from Microsoft, and I'll be including that in the description in case you are interested. I left the software downloading Windows 10 and installing it. After it was done downloading, it didn't give me the ability to upgrade without losing software. Fortunately enough, the files will be kept, but not the settings. I decided to just go with that. Anything is sacrificable, if that's a word, for the beloved long-awaited Windows 10, right? So I finally left it installing. It was really an easy process to do. Microsoft made it extremely easy, and that was for me so promising. After it was done installing, the first thing I checked was the very known start menu. It looked absolutely beautiful, but unfortunately animations were so slow. I thought it's because it's the first boot and this should happen. I realized the upgrade was running on the background and there is no choice but to keep it running, unless going on battery saver mode that I discovered later on. After the update made everything kind of like hell for me, but I'm gonna be talking about that in just a minute. So I decided to download all the updates, and that should fix the graphics problem and make it a bit faster, right? And after the updates were done, oh wait a minute, there was more updates every time. It was never done, which got me crazy. Graphics and audio drivers were never succeeded to probably update, and this got my machine real slow and the audio was really low for whatever reason. enjoyed some of great new features from Microsoft. I liked Edge Browser, though it was sometimes glitchy. I played a little with Cortana, but with time I found out that I was still using Windows legacy shortcuts. Alt tab to switch between the tabs, and Windows plus S to search, and then I type manually without having to ask Cortana or anything. I use Google Chrome as my main browser, and I only use store apps or metro apps when I'm in tablet mode. So then I realized I have been sacrificing Windows 10 reliability for Windows 10 features that I never really used. Except for multi-desktop feature, works really great when doing web design. Speaking of tablet mode though, Windows 10 is allegedly a beast in getting the best of your touchscreen. Well, I have a touchscreen on my Lenovo ThinkPad that I never thought I'll be using anyway. But with time since I got this laptop, I was using it way more often than I ever thought I would. A Windows 8, once again, was absolutely touch friendly for me. And this got me expecting way more reliability with this on Windows 10. Tablet mode was supposed to get the best out of your touchscreen. Don't get me wrong. Touch gestures and workflow in tablet mode in Windows 10 was okay, but I never felt the fluidity I used to feel in Windows 8.1. At some point in this Windows 10 discovery journey, I decided that I have had enough. Luckily for me, Windows 10 had one killer feature that I found most handy. That is, go back to a previous version of Windows, and this feature makes you able to go back to Windows 8.1 or Windows 7 or wherever you upgraded from. After some time considering it, and it was not a very long time, I didn't have to think so much, but going back to Windows 8.1 felt like the right thing to do at the moment. I plugged in my charger and left it doing its job. The process was again very easy to do. Good job Microsoft on that. And after like 30 minutes or maybe even less, my machine booted back to the lovely start screen of Windows 8.1, exactly how I left it before upgrading. I felt like home. It felt so fast, so reliable, so fluid, and way more friendly. After watching tons of previews on Windows 10 performance, maybe it was just my machine that's not suitable for this version of Windows, or maybe it's just not quite the time for me to upgrade yet, or maybe it's just that I didn't get the notification and I didn't install the proper version of Windows that Microsoft provides for my specific computer. Either way, I'm sure Microsoft will be doing a great job of optimizing it, making it faster and more convenient, but until then, my good old legacy version of Windows will do the job for me. I'm really looking forward to upgrade back again to a better version, or should I say build, of Windows 10, and maybe start using its features more effectively and enjoy its legendary fluidity and speed I never really felt. Note, this article represents my personal opinion and my experience with Windows 10. If you find it unfair and you have a Windows 10 running properly on your machine, that's great for you. I invite you for that. That said, I hope anyone finds this video helpful if they are considering upgrading to Windows 10 in the future. If you did, please like and share this video, maybe leave a comment if you want to. And let us know if you want to see more of this kind of video. That was Ahmad from Liquid Illusion. Thank you very much. Peace.